Hello everyone, welcome back to another video. As you can tell by the title, today I'm going to attempt to make a Basque cheesecake. It is a cheesecake that originated from New York. It has a kind of cookie crust to it, so it doesn't have to be too pretty looking. It's still gonna taste absolutely delicious, so I thought I would try make it and see where it goes. So let's get started. So the first thing to do is butter up a springform pan. And with the baking paper, you kind of want to crease it a little on each, on the edges, so it doesn't matter if it's folded like that. It's all lined up. I'm now going to leave this next to the oven and also preheat the oven to 400 degrees. Okay, so the first thing we have to do is mix together 2 pounds of cream cheese and sugar. So here I have 2 pounds of cream cheese, which is basically around 908 grams. That's a lot of cream cheese. It's all at room temperature, so I'm gonna put this in the mixer bowl. And now I'm gonna put in 1.5 cups of sugar. I ran out of normal sugar, so I'm gonna mix it a bit with brown sugar and hopefully it does the same thing. And the other half, put the attachment on. And now we can whiz it up. So I'm just gonna mix it up until it's nice and fluffy. It should take around 2 minutes. I've just paused it really quickly because I just wanna make sure they're scraping all the sides. And probably just mix it for around 1 more minute. And now we can turn it off just because there are no lumps. The sugar has mostly dissolved and it's more of a smooth consistency. So now what we're gonna do is add in the eggs. Okay, so according to the recipe, the next thing to do is beat up 6 eggs, which I have here, exactly 6 eggs. Put them 1 by 1. After we put one in, we have to wait 15 seconds, let it beat for a little bit, and then put the next one in. Egg number 1, 2. Oh my gosh, I put the entire eggshell in there. Oh no. 4, 5, 6. Now what we're gonna do is reduce it to low. Okay, so whilst it's on low, we're gonna add in 2 cups of heavy cream. 1 teaspoon of salt. And 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract. Beat it until it's combined, which will probably be around 30 seconds or so. Okay, I've taken the extension off because what we're gonna do is we're gonna sift in 1/3 of a cup of flour. Sift it into the cream cheese mixture. And we'll just scrape down the sides a little bit more, and all we have to do now is mix it all up. It should take around 10 seconds as long as the mixture is nice and smooth. Alrighty, so now I have got my very silky smooth cheesecake batter in here, and I've got my springform pan in here, and I have spruced up my baking sheet paper along it. I wanted to kind of have more like wrinkles everywhere just to give my cheesecake a bit more character when it comes out. Because the whole point is that it's supposed to look kind of burnt and messy. And we can pour it in. And now all we have to do is put our cheesecake into the oven for around 60 to 65 minutes until the top is kind of brownish but the inside is still nice and jiggly. Oh my gosh. Okay guys, I've just taken out of the oven. It has blown up so much. So what I now need to do is let it cool down before I take the mold off. And during this cooling period, it should deflate quite a bit. So it'll look very different very soon. What I'm gonna do now is unmold it, carefully take out the pan. So I'm gonna let this cool for probably around 20 to 30 minutes or so.
Can you just rip this out?
We've cooled down the cheesecake. It ended up taking a lot longer, but we're now gonna cut it up and see what it looks like on the inside. Hello, I just realized I didn't end the video for my Basque cheesecake video. It tasted not too bad. The 2 points that I would have in terms of if you guys do follow this recipe video, it would be number one, do not use rock salt. I use, as you saw, like the Himalayan pink salt, and because I was using like the automatic KitchenAid mixer, it didn't mix, ended up having it all like just combined at the bottom. So when I poured the batter into the pan, I just put all the salt in the middle and the center of the cheesecake ended up being super salty. So make sure that you incorporate it well and used I think it's kosher salt. Number two is when you test it to see if it's finished baking. I just tested the sides because I didn't want to ruin like the shape of the cake, but it's super important to also put the skewer in the center because turns out it just needed probably like an extra five minutes or so. It was just a little bit runny on the inside. So those are my 2 points. But yeah, that's it for this Basque cheesecake baking video. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to give a like and subscribe for more videos. And I'll see you in my next video. Thank you.